Well, Flea, I just had a chat to Anthony, and I was saying to him that the last time I had a chat to you both was on the eve of releasing One Hot Minute, and I guess I'll ask the same question. You must be happy the way this album has represented the band as it is now.
Yeah, well, as far as Dave being in the band and all that, that's all fine. I mean, it's good. We all feel good. We're playing together. I just want to make another record now. To me, that record is old now. I'm hearing new sounds in my head, and I want to record them and put them on a record, make a new record, ready to go on to something else.
Anthony was actually telling me that you're actually going to take a month off and go to Hawaii to write the songs for the album.
Yeah, we'll take a month and we'll write and then record. I just want to do it real quick. You know, the last record, we had so many problems leading up to it, and it took us so long to do it. This time, I just want to, boom, get in and record it. No wasting time, no screwing around. Just write it, record it, get it out, and play some more shows.
I mean, people love the album. Is it maybe because it took so long for you guys to do the album that you may have got tired, not tired of it, but that it represents too long a time with that album?
I'm not tired of it in terms of that. I don't like it. I think it's really good. I think it's a great record. I just already did it. I just want to do something else, you know. And I, because it took so long to make, doesn't make me like it less or like it more. And I don't think that it's better or worse because of that. It's just, you know, we had to deal with a lot of obstacles to get that record made. And I just want to make a new one, just because I want to make a new one.
Well, Flea, would you say that the band is more stable now?
Well, we're pretty stable. We're pretty stable. You know, there's always... We're a pretty eccentric, eclectic bunch of guys, you know, and you never know what's going to happen with us. But I feel, you know, right now I know that we can make a really good record better than anything we've ever done and get it done and do it. Mm-hmm. I know that. Mm-hmm. So I want to do it. I don't want to waste any time.
Right, are you enjoying being on the road? I mean, by that stage, you're rehearsing to go on the road.
Yeah, sometimes I like it. Like, sometimes I don't. Like, right now, I'm feeling a little burnt out. I didn't really sleep that good last night, and I got to go play right now and play tomorrow night. But, you know, so I like playing the shows. I don't always like being on the road. It's just like the lifestyle isn't always that good.
Right.
I like to be with my kid. I like to be stationary and to be creative, and a lot of times being on tour, as much as, you know, the playing of songs is good, I don't really enjoy it as much as the creative process of creating new things and, you know, exploring new areas of sound. And, you know, that's what really excites me. But, you know, at the same time, I'm an entertainer, I'm a performer. That's what I'm born to do. That's what I do. That's what I've been doing all my life. And I don't know what else to do, so I'll be doing it in a couple hours.
Now, I was actually surprised to hear from Anthony that you actually don't write songs on the road.
Yeah,
thoughts are there.
Yeah, actually, recently I've been writing a lot of stuff on the road, personally, yeah. But not usually, because we don't usually play, you know, we don't usually sound check or anything. We're just like, I see those guys on stage, you know.
Well, the videos of this current album have been pretty awesome in my mind. I mean, do you enjoy making videos?
You seem as if you do.
Yeah, sometimes I like them. Yeah. I like them sometimes. Actually, for me, I haven't been that happy with the videos on this album.
Right.
I feel like, I don't know. I haven't, like, on the last album when we made some of the videos, like when we made the Give It Away, when I was like, that's cool, you know, and on those new ones, it's like I like the Warped one, and my friend's one is cool. I like them all okay, but I don't think none of them really knock me out.
Now, Flea, I believe it was your concept in the making of Aeroplane.
Yeah, I wanted to do a big bodacious thing, like an old musical, you know. Yeah,
Busby Berkeley type of thing.
Busby Berkeley, and then we got into, in specific, what's the girl's name? We did the old movies, The Swimmer.
Oh, Esther Williams.
Yeah, Esther Williams, because those are, you know, really beautiful. We just, you know, we got those movies, That's Entertainment, and That's Entertainment 2, and That's Entertainment 3. Are you familiar with those films?
Yes.
Yeah, they just, like, categorize all those old musicals, and so...
Now, on your acting side, I mean, has your agent rung lately? I mean, is there any scripts around? I mean, are you going to go and do another movie?
I've been asked to do. I get asked to do films once in a while, you know, fairly frequently, and I almost always say no. But I'd like to do some good ones, you know, for good directors. You know, it'd be different if I really needed money and stuff, and I wasn't really busy playing music. I'd probably be doing a lot more acting.
Uh-huh.
But I'm just waiting for the right scripts, the right time, you know, the right director, the right feeling about the whole thing. You know. Actually, I did a film that's coming out probably in October called Whiskey Down with Virginia Madsen, Sean Patrick Flannery, and Ernie Hudson, and John Lurie.
Right.
It's a good film.
Now, what's this I hear that since you've been in the country, you've become an A&R man?
No, I'm not an A&R. I could never be a record company guy.
No, tell us a story.
But, I just did this thing for the Triple J radio show, and they asked me to do my five favorite songs of all time, which is really impossible because I like such a wide variety of music, and way more than five songs have, like, touched me deeply enough that I could have heard them once and then die. But, they asked me the five, and I picked one band, a band called Leaf, who live right down. I have a house sort of in a very obscure spot in the south coast of New South Wales in Australia, and I try to spend as much time there as possible, and there's a band there down the street, these 14-year-old kids, and they have a band called Leaf, and they gave me a demo tape, which is recorded in a very lo-fi sort of way, and they're very much learning about playing their instruments and songwriting and stuff, so it's nice to hear someone who's earnest and, still very much in the learning process of being in a rock band and to help them out. So I put their song on the radio.
Do you get much chance to listen to other, like a gamut of music?
I listen to all kinds of things. I listen to, like, contemporary rock music. Yeah. I listen to old rock music. I listen to jazz. I listen to reggae. I listen to African music. I listen to, classical music. I listen to Tibetan chanting music. I listen to so much. I like all different kinds of stuff.
Right.
I like anything that has passion and heart and originality.
Now, Australia seems to be coming your second home. Is this where you get away from it all?
Yeah, well, when I get to come to Australia and to be at my house in Australia, it is the most peaceful, happy time for me. I love it here. I love Australia. I love being here. I love going to that house down there. I'm trying to learn how to surf. I take lots of walks in the bush. I jump in the ocean. I play with my daughter. I walk on the beach. I just look at the stars at night. I catch fish and barbecue them in my backyard.
Sounds
and, you know, for a lot of people, you know, that's like, they do that stuff and they're used to it. But for me, it's I'm a city boy. You know, I grew up on the dirty streets of Hollywood, California.
Yeah.
And for me to get to do that is just, you know, it's just amazing. It's incredible. And I thank my lucky stars every time I can do something like that. And people that, live in small country towns and have those things should realize how lucky they are, you know, to live a peaceful life like that.
Well, listen, enjoy the rest of the tour. And look forward to, if you say this album should be out this time next year, right?
Yeah, I hope so. Okay. You know, unless, the Chili Peppers, anything could happen.
Okay, thanks, mate.
Bye. See you, Molly.
For sure.